a spot of Germany in the heart of Rome. On the highest hill of the city, the Quirinale, an exhibition about the German-born Catholic painter Hans Memling has opened its doors.
The intention was to bring about an exhibit of a Flemish master while underlining all his connections to the Italian tradition. It is an exhibit that has a lot to do with Flemish painters in Italy, especially Memling. This is an aspect which has prior not been emphasized enough in other exhibitions around the world.
The exhibition tells the story about how the German and Flemish finesse was an influence of the Renaissance, generally accredited only to Italy.
Memling was actually never in Italy, at least not from what we know from the documents. He worked in Bruges, though, a city which was the center of stories and of meetings of the greatest people in Europe at that time. He must have met the great art patrons of Italy in Bruges. This work meant that he had to tailor some of his works to the taste of his customers, so he adopted the taste of the Italian Renaissance. Afterwards, those paintings were sent to Italy. They were commissioned in Bruges and then set out to Florence, Milano, and Genoa, and Venice. Therefore, the Italian artist got to know his works and learned to appreciate them.
Le opere che gli artisti italiani hanno maggiormente conosciuto e apprezzato.
The relation of the Flemish style and the Italian style exceeds influence. It becomes actually copy.
A crucial element of the exhibition is shown in the last room of the exhibition rooms by putting next to each other two fundamental works. The Blessing Christ on my right of Memling, which today is in the collection of the White Palace in Genoa, and the copy, the exact copy, if you will, that was done by Ghirlando a couple of years later, which is located today in the Museum of Philadelphia in the United States. It is the proof that testifies to the interest, the fascination, but also, if you will, the submission of the great Italian Renaissance with its humanistic ideas to the perfect execution and methods of the Flemish painters. The great master Ghirlando, who had one of the most flourishing workshops in the second half of the 14th century, falls to his knees in front of this great work and copied it. It is interesting because it is an exact and faithful copy, at the same time a copy that testifies to the difference of the two ways of looking at it. The work of Memling has the strong naturalistic character visible especially in the details of pain, the blood, the sad expression of Christ, which precisely shows his dominion of oil painting. It is even a little shadowy, almost Caravaggio-like, a strong, dark, light contrast that lets us think already of the mature Renaissance. Ghirlando painted a splendid interpretation, which is nonetheless proto-Renaissance, so with very clear lines and contours, more static. It has clear ties to the ancient world. Also, the dark-light contrast is less present. The atmosphere of the figure is more suave.
Memling's art can be summed up with the words of a famous art interpreter: he occasionally enchants, never offends, and never overwhelms.